Holy biscuits, you guys. I can't believe it's been a full year. Now, my channel has two dates. Well, technically three if you look at the very, 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 very first video I uploaded. Its birth being November 4th, 2011. And of course, its launch at July 25th, 2020. We are celebrating its launch. That was when I officially decided I'm going to start making videos. And holy crap, I have learned so much in a year alone. But before I get into that, before I get too deep, I want to take the time to thank all of my peeps who have stuck by me and supported me. Shout out to all of my closest friends and family who have taken the time for me. I love y'all so much. And if you're new here, welcome! Great to have you. If you've been here, I am so honored that you've continued to stick around, and I appreciate and value your support, so thank you so much. Anyway, by the time I uploaded my first Minecraft episode, which is to me the official launch date, July 25th, 2020, when I first did that, I had about 3 subscribers. And 2 of them subbed to me way back in 2018. It's really crazy that despite my gaps and extended breaks in the past year, that I have over 40 subs. And again, thank you guys so much. So, what has this past year taught me? Well, a couple of things. Perseverance, commitment, strategies, a change in mentality, and of course, taking the good with the bad. So let's start talking off about perseverance. Ah yes, perseverance, not only a great comic title, which I have as a Pokemon fan comic up on my Tapas. You guys should take a look at it. Anyway, Perseverance, not only a great comic title, but exceedingly difficult to personally hold yourself to that standard. It is really difficult. Gotta say, the road to keep going is long and arduous, but it's not all that bad. In this first year, I had come to the realization that nobody can make this channel grow except me. And discovering that was both exciting and a little scary. As I continued to upload my first series, which was my Minecraft series of gaining courage, I started to realize that this just wasn't doing so well. And as bummed as I was about it, I told myself, nope, we're gonna stick to our guns and we're gonna keep persevering. We're gonna keep pressing on. As I continued to press on, it eventually led me down the road of my first speed draw. And I gotta say, I was pleasantly surprised to see that it had more views and watcher retention than my previous Minecraft episode. And so with that, I was like, hey, you know, my art and what I talk about with my art actually seems to be some good content that people like, so I'm probably going to start doing more of those. Which I did. I started to do more of these fun speed draws and talk about art-related topics that I was passionate about. But then another challenge hit me. I suddenly felt pressured to draw, and I realized that those speed draws actually took much more time to record than gameplay. It's like it became a trade-off. Gameplay was easier to record, but longer to edit, but speed draws were longer to record and easier to edit. It was flipped. And because I felt like pressured to draw, I feel like that's why my first couple of speed draws, my first handful, aren't as good as my latest ones. I started to rush myself, which ended up not being the greatest drawings to produce. But at the same time, I feel like they're satisfactory and I'm going to keep them as is and just keep going. And it wasn't until after my birthday special speed draw where I drew some fun little memes and everything, I took a break because I didn't know what I wanted. And after that break, I came back 3 months later and made the rookie mistake of making a channel update video when I should have focused on just creating more content. Not too long after that, I uploaded my first non-lock episode. And as soon as I switched series, I went from Minecraft to this non-lock episode, it sort of cemented the fact that my Minecraft series Gaining Courage was basically, in fact, dead, and I had to keep going. Yet, as soon as that first non-lock episode uploaded, another 3-month break hit me because that was when I started questioning if what I was doing was worth it. And so, this is where the commitment part made its grand appearance. After that last 3-month break, I finally decided, you know what? No. It is time to stop play flirting with YouTube and being a content creator. And thus my next video, I expressed my struggles of being a content creator and a YouTuber in a speed draw of my newly updated banner. And uploading that video, it actually really filled me with nerves, because the idea to put my foot down and really go for this thing, this career, this dream seemed almost absolutely contradictory to the values I have grown up with. Being a creator, a YouTuber, isn't exactly a stable job, and that is such a red flag in my family, but I couldn't deny that I just wanted this so much and so badly. For the first time in my life, I decided to make such an impactful decision for me. Yeah, I will admit, I worry that is this a wrong decision? Is this something I may end up regretting? Yet at the same time, that's why it's all the more important to press forward, to stay committed to this. One day, I will look back and say, whoa, I can't believe how far I've come. And actually, in fact, just in a year alone, it's mind-boggling that I already have all of y'all with me sitting here. And it's just been such an honor and a privilege. Commitment made me realize it was time to get serious. I couldn't fall into the pitfall of blindly uploading content, hoping something is gonna hit that algorithm sweet spot. And once it do, it will allow my channel to blow up. I couldn't fall into those pitfalls. I realized that, no, I need to do one better. So after I realized, okay, I'm committed to this thing, and I'm gonna turn serious about it, that's when it dawned on me that I actually needed to refine and polish my knowledge of the platform. I needed to learn, how do I play the game? How do I do this YouTube journey that so many others before me have done? This led me into learning new strategies. Yep, it was time to learn some new strategies. I went out to find videos, tutorials, anything and everything on how to become an effective YouTuber. And that eventually led me down into a path of finding an amazing, thank you speech. I found an amazing content creator coach, Vanessa Lau, and you can bet that I absolutely binged her content, especially pertaining to YouTube. I'll be sure to put like maybe a tag, her channel will be in the description, it'll be in a pinned comment. I'll make sure that you get to see it. This also made me realize that the internet has allowed these resources to blow up. There's all kinds of podcasts, all kinds of even channels alone, even talking about how to become an effective YouTuber. Personally, I actually learned something in the process of trying to learn all these things. I also learned that I should never watch one of these once. It is okay to rewatch and or relearn something to ensure that things really stick, making sure that this new information really does hit home. And that's just been something that I've personally struggled with, because I've always been the type of individual, especially when it pertains to my art, of, oh, once I look at something, I don't need to read the how-to art tutorial. I just need to look at it. And then suddenly I'll just osmosis all the information and just keep it all locked away, and I can just recall it like a web page or a Google. And no. It took me a while to realize, actually, no, my memory isn't as good as I think it is. I should probably take the time to rewatch this stuff, relearn it, reread it, whatever it is, because that ideology from my art is starting to bleed into my content, and that is not a good thing. So, I try my hardest to retain all of the useful information I come across, and then the second thing that I learned, I also realized that sometimes when you are learning all of this stuff, it's so much to take in. It's so much to process. So it's also a good thing that maybe I should just focus on a couple of things at a time
And that ended up being much better than attempting to sponge up all of the information in one sitting. Like, I got this new thing called TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is basically a tool that helps YouTubers and content creators basically optimize their videos. I feel like that's the best way that I can put it bluntly, a good way to help optimize your videos. But just getting this tool, it's like you get a whole bunch of other tools with it. And it was a little overwhelming. And I was like, holy biscuits, what am I supposed to focus on? So I decided, you know what? I will learn everything at my own pace. But right now I'm going to be focusing on keywords and tag words and optimizing my SEO, search engine optimization, and focusing a little bit on thumbnails. Which also means that I also had to figure out which items I should prioritize. And for example, like, I'm an artsy person. So that means as an artsy individual, I want to make sure that my thumbnails are eye-catching. I want to make sure that my thumbnails are one of my top priorities because it's a picture and I love pictures. So I want to make sure that the colors are all right, the contrast is good, text is good, you know, the picture and the context of everything is good. That to me is a much bigger priority than setting up, say, chapters in my videos, which I know is equally as important, but for me isn't a top priority. So speaking of thumbnails, I actually learned that they do need to be in high definition. A lot of my old thumbnails, they were like maybe 600 by 400 pixels. And no, your thumbnails should be in high definition. They should be 1280 by 720 pixels, which is something I had recently discovered this past year and I'm willing to share with all of you. Now, on to from learning new strategies, it also went into a change into mentality. That was the next thing that I learned from this past year. And honestly, a change in mentality has been the hardest thing to work at for me. Back in 2018, when I had a soft launch with my friend Tail Saria, I know exactly why that channel failed. In the end, I wasn't in the right headspace. So that's why I eventually backed down. I just had no confidence in my content and what I was doing. Even my recordings sounded a little rougher in those videos, which you are not going to see, so don't bother asking. You're not going to see all those old recordings. Deep down, I really felt like what I was doing wasn't acceptable in the eyes of my parents. And it was only until last year I had to break away from that mentality that I needed their approval in order to go on my YouTube journey. I had to switch the way I was thinking about this. In fact, it made me realize that, you know what? Not everyone is going to approve. Some people may even go out of their way to try and stop me, whittle me down, but I refuse. I also had to change the way I viewed my content. In 2018, I felt embarrassed and honestly didn't show it off. I just kind of tucked it away like, oh, this is kind of something I'm doing on the side, but I don't really want to show anybody. But now, anytime a video goes up, I feel a sense of just absolute sheer joy when I do. It makes me realize, oh my goodness, I made this thing and I'm more than happy to share it with all of y'all. I share it on Twitter, I share it with my close friends and family on Facebook, I share it on my personal Discord with some friends over there. I even text a couple of friends when a new video is out. I just shamelessly share it because I am proud of it and I'm passionate about it and I want to share that passion with other people. Now, every time a video went up, I had to take the good with the bad. Many times, according to the YouTube dashboard and studio, my videos would hardly be placed in that first spot. You know, views, likes, all those numbers. Gotta say, it is not a good idea to focus on them because they can be discouraging. Now, let me be clear, it is perfectly normal to feel and have that moment of, aw, man. And I would know. When I first started scripting for this video, I went through a small little up and down wave of subscribers. I had like, I was up at 42 and then two people left and then I was down at 40, but I kept going. And after I released my Super Mario RPG videos, I eventually got two more subscribers. And so, yeah, it did sting. It stung when those two suddenly left. But instead of dwelling on that sting and allowing it to fester, I had to take a step back, took a nice deep breath. And you know what? I wished those people who unsubbed the best. But I'm gonna pivot my focus to the remaining amazing individuals who are still here, cheering me on and patiently waiting for the next installment. And I'm not gonna deny the sheer jubilation I have when I see another subscriber, a new like, a comment. You know, it just warms my heart, and I'm so grateful for all of you being here. So it's okay to feel or be knocked down, but it's even more important to keep getting up. You gotta take the good with the bad. I have learned a lot this past year, and I'm looking forward to more content, more videos, more ways to entertain and engage with my fantastic audience that is with me. YouTube is something that I really want to do. Making videos, chatting with you guys. A year ago today, I never would have guessed how wonderful it feels to do the thing that I love and love doing it every small step of the way. So here's to one official year on the platform, and here's to you, yes you, behind the screen, whichever screen you prefer, computer, phone, doesn't matter, to all of you watching, thank you. Let's have another amazing year together. So thank you for watching, and remember, my fantastically wonderful peeps, be awesome, be you, Akemi, out.